This is another Graham Logan radio production.
Music and chat from now right the way through until 2 o'clock. Our first guest on the programme this morning, as I mentioned right at the start, we're going to be joined in the first hour by Paul Marazzi. Paul, welcome to the show.
Hey, Graham, how you doing, mate?
I'm all right. How about yourself?
I'm very, very well, thank you.
Paul, where is it I'm speaking to you from today?
I'm actually in Port Mulgrave, which is just on the coast. It's in Yorkshire.
Paul, what I'd like to do first off is ask you to give us a very brief summary of your early musical career.
Well, I've spent probably about 5 years, that was all in the making and career of A1, a boy band.
Now, let's remind people about A1. How long were they actually going for in the early days?
I think it was about 4 years from getting on the road and releasing to the time when they disbanded, when I left.
How many albums and hit singles had A1 had?
Oh, I think it was about, in this country, I think we had 12 singles and we released 3 albums.
And what would you say was the most successful?
Well, I think album-wise, I think our second album, the A-List, was the most successful as far as sales went. But I think we had the song Caught in the Middle was our biggest-selling single. I think that was off that, and that was off the third album.
All right, we'll give that a little play as we go by our chat here. Now, as far as A1 are concerned as well, were you writing any of the material?
I didn't actually write the majority of the stuff. The rest of the guys did most of the writing, to be honest. But I did get my hand in a few songs on album tracks and B-sides. But most notably, I co-wrote Caught in the Middle with Ben from A1. So I think that was the biggest success I'd had songwriting. So I'm very proud of that song.
And how did A1, popularity-wise, in other countries go?
Well, we had lots of popularity in the, the East, Southeast Asia, and also Norway and Sweden.
When you mention Norway, of course, they got involved representing Norway in the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yes, they did.
And how did they get involved in that?
I'm not really sure how they did that. I spoke to Ben a few times. I just think it was just a matter of, I think they were working out of Norway. I think their actual record company is based in Norway now. And they got in that way, I think. I'm not really sure.
All right. Paul, what we're about to do, that single that you mentioned that A1 had, is Caught in the Middle. What can you tell us about that song?
It was just probably written in about 20 minutes. We were in Chris Porter's studio down near London. And the song just came together in, like I said, a matter of minutes, and it was just a good pop song.
Well, what I'd like to do is play that this morning to remind our audience here on A1 and classic track from them, and after that talk a little bit about your more modern music.
Can't erase. It seems to stay. caught in the middle. But even though I'm someone new, all I can think about is you. And now I'm caught in the middle.
And with us live on the air at the moment, previously with A1, is Paul Marazzi. Paul, welcome back to the show.
Hello.
Hiya. Paul, we mentioned at the beginning that you were previously with A1. How long have you been away from them now?
It's got to be a good 10 years now.
Okay. Just whilst you were there, you were involved as well in the cover of Take On Me, is that correct?
That's correct, yeah. That was our first single off our second album.
Why did they decide to actually cover that song?
Well, I think there was a bit of, obviously, the connection with Norway, obviously with Aha and Christian, who's from Norway. And I think it was part gimmick, you know. I mean, I think a lot of covers are, and we did the whole kind of big video with all the special effects and everything. So it did well for us. It got us quite a few fans in places where we didn't really have many before. So, yeah. I think it was a good choice of single.
Yeah, fair enough. It did quite well as well, didn't it?
Yeah, it did actually, yeah. It won a few awards from it.
Since then, we are going to be talking this morning a little bit about solo material that you've recently been involved in.
Yeah.
And how would you describe the new music?
I don't know. I think it's come naturally from some previous projects I've done, which has just been going out and doing acoustic kind of soul music with Blue Eyed Soul, an outfit I was from last year and this year that I was leading. And we wanted more original songs in, so I just started writing for that project, and some great songs came out of it.
Now, with regards to 2012, what plans have you got?
Well, I'm just working on stuff at the moment. I'm still writing songs. I'm in the studio today, actually, to put vocals down for a new song. So hopefully that will come out as good as Guess What They Call It, which is the song that's being played now.
Do you think there's a possibility of an album this year?
I'd like to work towards an album. The main thing for me, though, is to get out there and do some live gigs and see the fans again, hopefully go over to Southeast Asia and bring a show over there. I'd love to be able to do an album, to get a reason to actually do an album release one. That'd be great.
And this new track we're going to be giving our listeners a touch off this morning, and have you had much feedback on it so far?
Not really. I mean, I think you'll be the first people to actually play it in this country, which is brilliant. I've only had friends and family and other people that I've been working with just saying, yeah, we really like the song, just give it a crack. So I have.
Well, can you tell us a bit about the song?
Yeah, I just sat down with the guitar and I was just working on songs we did in the set, and we needed some more new material. I wanted to put some more in. And I just sat down and just started writing. I mean, I think it came from, obviously, my love of Motown and soul music. I think it comes out a bit in the song, but it's a pop song, you know.
Well, that's a fair description. With regards, more material, more information that your fans require, is there a website they should check out?
Yes, there is a website. It's paulmarazzi.com. And we've just started updating that again, so we'll have new songs on there, some obviously new photos. And we're just going to keep updating that as much as we can with any gigs that are coming up or anything.
Paul, all I can say is all the very best with this brand new release that's about to come out, and also with 2012. Can I ask you to introduce this for us?
Yes, of course. This song is called Guess What They Call It Round Here, and I'm Paul Marazzi, and thank you very much, Graham, for your time.
Been lovely talking to you. Thanks a lot, Paul.
Cheers, mate. Bye-bye.
My heart been left out in the rain, solitary and locked in chains. Hey, can you rescue?
On air this morning with us right here on East Lothian FM was Paul Marazzi. Once again, thanks to Paul for joining us. All the best with the brand new single we've just gone and played you.